System maintenance.
Hello students. Today we are going to see about the different types of motherboard. In previous video we have seen about the description of motherboard and function of the motherboard. In this video we are going to cover about the different types of motherboard. What motherboard that were used in earlier times or in earlier computers, and how the different types of motherboard has been developed, what are the different types of motherboard, how the different companies created or manufactured or developed the different types of motherboard, how the functions and features were added in the motherboard, and why the different types of motherboard are used in a PC. According to different types of processor, different types of motherboard are there. So first of all, we are going to see about the AT motherboard, that is called Advanced Technology Motherboard. It is the oldest of the main board. This motherboard were used in earlier 286 by 386 or 486 computer. The AT motherboard consists of advanced technology power connectors, so that's why it is called the AT motherboard. There are two power connectors of 6 pin each mounted at the AT motherboard. AT motherboards were available in the early 80s. In the era of IBM computable personal computer, the AT form factor referred to as the dimension and layout of the form factor. It means it refers to the size of the motherboard. Many third party after that manufactured and produced motherboard compatible with the IBM AT form factor used at AT and its variants. The power connector for AT motherboards are two nearly identical 6 pin plug and sockets as designed by IBM. The connectors are mechanically keyed so that each can only be inserted in its correct position. But in some case, clone manufacturer cut cost and used unkeyed connectors. For that, unfortunately, the user can't distinguish between the different ports or power connectors. So it is possible for them and many people to damage their motherboard when they try to improperly connect. In 1985, IBM introduced Baby AT. As soon after, all computer makers abandoned AT for the cheaper and smaller Baby AT form factor. From those that used 286 processor to the Pentium 5 and a limited number of Pentium 2 system, this motherboard have similar mounting hole position and the same 8 card slot location as those with the AT form factor, but are 2 inches narrower and marginally shorter. The size and flexibility of this kind of motherboard were the key to success of this format. Now we will see about the next type of motherboard, that is ATX motherboard. The ATX motherboard started in 90s and are still available. The ATX connector on the motherboard consists of a single connector. These boards are used for P2 by P3 or P4 processors. The ATX stands for Advanced Technology Extended, as this motherboard configuration developed in the mid-90s and is still in use. The ATX motherboard is an important over the previously working motherboard such as AT. The ATX is the most common motherboard design which is used in smaller boards. The dimension of a full-size standard ATX board range in 12 into 9.6 inches. The ATX motherboard seems to have gone through a lots of upgrade in recent time. The modern ATX motherboard has many advantages over its predecessors, Some of these features and uses of modern ATX motherboards are, we are going to study, that first is more powerful phases for cleaner and more stable power. More clearance around the CPU socket to accommodate those huge aftermarket heatsink means it can we can attach the big heatsink upon the CPU socket. Means it have more gap for the heatsink fan. Wider gaps between expansion slot for better graphics card cooling. Means is if the two expansion slots are there, between that more gaps are given for to attach or for to give a better gap between the two slots for a better ventilations. This picture shows the Pentium 1 and Pentium 2 processor motherboard and Pentium 4 motherboard is look like this. Now we are going to see about the micro ATX motherboard. The micro ATX motherboard is a smaller than the typical ATX motherboard with a dimension of 9.6 into 9.6 inches. But some manufacturers have a dimension reduced to 9.6 into 8.1 inches. Most of the modern ATX motherboard have a maximum of 7 PCI expansion slot, but while micro ATX board only have a maximum of 4 PCI express expansion slot. Micro ATX motherboard has many advantages, like it is compact and smaller than ATX motherboard, means it is a very small motherboard comparing to the other ATX motherboard, and it support more ports and slot than ATX. And micro ATX motherboard is a cheap motherboard which comes under the budget comparing to the other ATX motherboard and ITX motherboard. Now we are going to see about the mini ITX motherboard. The mini ITX motherboard ranges 6.7 into 6.7 inches in dimension, which is very smaller than any other conventional motherboard. Mini ITX is a very smaller in its dimension comparing to the other ATX micro or mini ATX motherboard. Some features and advantages of mini ITX motherboard are the smaller size and fan less cooling system, which enable it to low power consumption, which means this motherboard consume less power comparing to the other motherboards. And mini ITX board can be used in any case, means CPU case, which are designed for ATX, micro ATX and other ATX variant if desired, because it is very compact design, so it can be assembled in any case, in any smaller design case, CPU case. Now we are going to see about the EATX motherboard. The EATX motherboard is an extended ATX motherboard, and its size is enormous compared to ATX motherboard. It means it is bigger than a normal motherboard. But it doesn't matter with the size, it has many features and uses. It has many lack than a typical motherboard. The EATX is primarily used for gaming. It means the purpose of this motherboard is maximum used by the gamers. This motherboard can be expanded to have a huge memory and can accommodate a powerful CPU with more cores. Features and advantages of ATX motherboard. It has a lot of PCI slot and DIN slot. It means we can add extra expansion cards and RAMs in this motherboard for smoother use. This board have an inbuilt Wi-Fi, so we can't have to add additional Wi-Fi driver to use Wi-Fi connection. And sound card, we don't have to install additional sound card in this board. Onboard troubleshooting features and powerful VRM. A maximum of 128 GB RAM can be installed on this motherboard. It's a very huge amount of memory we can add in this motherboard. These are the types of motherboard which can be used conventionally. Moreover, there are several features like overclocking, USB 3.0 and USB 3.1, Thunderbolt, liquid cooling expansion, and many more. Like looking at this, we can conclude this one to be a best motherboard if you are thinking of building a high-end PC. Now we see about the BTX motherboard. The BTX motherboard stands for Balanced Technology Extended. BTX is the form factor of motherboard, originally intended to be the replacement of the aging ATX motherboard form factor in late 2004 and early 2005. The ATX and BTX standard were both proposed by Intel. The first company to implement BTX was the Gateway, followed by Dell and MPC. Next is Pico BTX. Pico BTX is a motherboard form factor that is meant to miniaturize the 12.8 into 10.5 inch BTX standard. Pico BTX motherboard measures 8 into 10.5 inches. It is a very small. This is a smaller than many current micro-size motherboard. In the first month of a production, the ATX and BTX motherboards were so similar that moving a BTX motherboard to an ATX case was possible and vice versa. This was possible because the first BTX motherboard where ATX motherboard turned upside down, except for the components location that really were BTX position. It means the upper part of the motherboard in ATX where in BTX came in down position. Later, the BTX form factor had a big change by turning it into mirror image of a ATX standard. It means new motherboard design, both standards are incompatible. BTX motherboard are left side right compared to ATX, not upside down. It made the mounting this BTX motherboard opposite side of a case. It means in many cases this motherboard is not compatible or not be fixed. BTX power supply units can be exchanged with newer ATX 12 volt unit, but not with older ATX power supply that don't have the extra 4 pin 12 volt connector. The ATX 12 volt standard introduced later after the old ATX power supply. Initially, only Gateway and Dell offered computers with the new format. So today we have covered the types of motherboards. The first one we have studied about the AT motherboard, ATX, Micro ATX, Mini ATX, EATX, BTX and Pico BTX.